Thank you. the talks we had, the tears we shared, they all mean so much. Our years of HHS have hopefully taught us a lot about people. There is no new taught personality here. The rebel, the square, the pacifist, the chief Joanne, the jock, and the party animal. We've learned to look ahead to the future, but also to the present today. We all have someone or something that we care about. They give us the strength to go one day at a time. And in a world that is as fast-paced as today, that's very important. In a few years, you might wonder where all the time is gone. You shouldn't ruin today by worrying about tomorrow. There isn't enough time. We've complained a lot about just about everything, but deep down, we'd like to miss it. Here we were individuals, not numbers without the school symbol. What I'd like to know of the friends that I've had, we've been through a lot together and helped each other to live for today. I pray that we'll keep in touch even after we've left Henning and started on our own. I'd like to thank you all and wish us luck in the future. I'd especially like to thank my parents for putting up with me for 18 years. God bless you all and remember to always live for today.
Thank you. Municipal Hardina, board member, class of 1987. Faculty, parents, family, friends. As I thought about preparing a message for all of you, I could not help but ask a very significant question. Where will we, graduating class of 1987, be 10 years from now? What will each of us be doing? Some of us will be teachers, some of us farmers, some of us homemakers, doctors, some of us may be politicians. We have all heard the preamble to our Constitution. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice and ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, to ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. We are celebrating the Constitution's bicentennial. For 200 years, this document has been the supreme law of the land. People like George Washington, Ben Franklin, and James Madison played an important part in the writing of this charter. What kind of men were they? They were men of dreams. They were men of hope. They were men who yearned for freedom, and they were willing to pay the price. We, the class of 1987, need to be like the people who formed and shaped our country. We need to be willing to dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear the unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go. Wherever we are, we can each be sure that it will be our dreams for tomorrow that will carry us there. Just like our founding fathers, we need to be dreamers. We need to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far. As we look to the future, we need to keep on keeping on. Sometimes our dreams may meet disappointment. Sometimes our hopes may bring us frustration or even tears. For years, I worked to be the best basketball player I could be. My dream had a hope. We have a hope, and we work to achieve that hope. We had a successful season, but our dream was not realized. Our dream was like a fog and disappeared. But did the framers of our country go over and die and make mad resistance to their dream? No. They kept on and on. I'm going to keep on too. Thomas Paine once said, "These are the times that try men's soul." We, the class of 1987, have many challenges that face us today, and for the sake of future generations, it is imperative that we not shrink from our dreams. Let me close by sharing a message with you, my classmates. Dear fellow classmates, we finally made it. It's been tough, and we worked hard, but the future looks promising. I really wish the best for all of you, and hope you attain your dream. Let me leave you with one final thought. If you dream it, live it. Your friend, Troy. Thank you.
Remember our sophomore year,
when we did the We Are the World skit in the classroom choir carnival. We even got Brian Green to dress up as Willie Nelson because he was the only one in our class for 10 years. Remember when we finally got our driver's license? We thought it would take forever. Remember how much fun we had at homecoming this year? And Randy and Laura were crowned homecoming king and queen. Remember our sports seasons this year? Our infamous crush crew? But in a few years, we'll be saying, remember our graduation? I'm sure we will look back and realize that what we learned in school is just the foundation on which we're going to continue building for the rest of our lives. There's so much more that we have to look forward to and experience. We can do so many things in our lives. By using things we have learned from our past, we can prepare ourselves and take the challenge to fulfill our lives. Tonight will probably be the last time we will all be together. Some of us will never see each other again. But what's neat about graduating is that we can take what we've learned from our friends and classmates with us, even though we're no longer together. We've been talking about learning things we can't recall in textbooks, but we can't forget that in these 13 years of school, we've also gained a valuable academic education. It will help some of us continue our education in college, tech school, or whatever we decide to go into. How many times have we heard ourselves saying, why do we have to learn this? I'll never have to know this. Well, now is a good opportunity to thank the school's administration, faculty, and staff for helping us learn those things we didn't know important, but will soon realize are important. Parents are others that we appreciate, but seldom share these thoughts with. Their patient guidance through these years has helped us to get where we are tonight. Thank you, parents, for always being there for us. We love you. Tonight, when the graduating class of 1987 prepares to leave, we hope that we can leave a part of us behind. Partly because we want to start our new lives fresh and full of optimism. And partly because we want a part of our spirit and excitement to remain here for others to remember us. We also hope to take a few things with us. We hope to take all of the knowledge and experience we have gained here in Henning to use to the best of our abilities. We are glad to take our diplomas that we will receive that show what we have accomplished and worked for all of these years. We want to make memories with us. Memories that we cherish and will remember fondly for the rest of our lives. Finally, we especially want to take our love and friendship with us. We will be leaving familiar faces, but that doesn't mean that they will be forgotten. I would like to wish the graduating class of 1987 the best of luck in their future. May all your dreams come true. And remember, friends have been forever. God bless you all.
Scott Allen Brim.
Vivo Okuka. Patricia Ann Renicky. Angela Sue Rucknell. Jerry Mae Smith. Jeffrey John Stuby. Laura Ruth Petter. J. Patrick Bolden. Pamela Joy Wolleben. James Lee Wallenberg. Stephanie Christine Witt. Randall Stephen Witt. Winter class of 1987, ladies and gentlemen.
Congratulate Brent, he's all by himself over there, right straight in front of me. Why? So you can get people out of the way?
No.
You don't have sound on, babe.
Yes. Naturally. I don't know why I'm doing this, can't see anybody anyway. I didn't have it on when they threw their hats in the air. Well, I didn't know what they were going to do it. They did it since they all got out here. In Google. Where's Ken? First Lori, have you seen her?
Is that Blackwell?
Yeah.
There he is, there.
Excuse me. I want to get Karen to get up the breath.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.